Hello friends, and welcome to this demonstration video in which we will take a quick overview at the MARG manufacturing software and how can it be used and what is manufacturing. In MARG, we can maintain the manufacturing process through four different modules: production, quality control, inventory and accounting. Now let's understand through a flow chart that how is MARG manufacturing software used and how can it be implemented. So this is the manufacturing process flow, where first we have production planning. In production planning, we see requirement of raw materials and packing materials and budget analysis. After that, we require a quotation through a vendor. Then that quotation goes through approval. And then we generate purchase order. And after the purchase order is generated, the goods are received. And then we do its purchase entry. After purchase entry, we have two options, that whether you want the purchase materials to go under testing or not for quality check. Now, after the stock is gone through the testing, they will either get approved or they will get disapproved. If the stock is approved, then they'll be transferred to the store, and if it's rejected, then it will go back to the supplier. After that, a requisition slip is generated of raw materials and production material, which has to be transferred from the store to production department. So that is called requisition slip. If in the requisition slip some raw materials or packing materials are yet to be added, then you can do addition of raw materials or packing material. After the semi-finished goods which have been generated in the production department, you have two options, that whether you want to send those materials for testing or not. After their testing, some might be rejected and some might be pending. After that, we receive our finished goods, and after that we generated sale order. Then invoice, excise and gate passing is generated. Then after that, you need bank letter and cover note. Then the entry is done in accounts department in inventory. Then outstanding taxation. So this is a complete manufacturing flow. So now let's understand what all is required at what process and at what level what all is needed. So at entry level, we need these things: purchase requirement sheet as per production planning, purchase order and purchase order management, goods receipt note, under testing slip, inward register, and ledger and outstanding of suppliers. And in quality control department, these things are required: testing requisition slip, certificate, rejection list, rejection order, approved, and rejection list. And in the production department, these things are needed. And these are the requirements of finished quality control department. So these are the requirement and complete process of a manufacturing unit. Now let me implement and show you a short demo of MARG manufacturing software. So this is our software. Firstly, we need to make masters in any software. In MARG software, we mainly have to make four masters, that is the ledger master, inventory master, testing master and formula master. Firstly, let's see ledger master. Here already we have created ledgers of different groups like debtors ledger, creditors ledgers, bank ledgers, production department ledger, quality control ledger. You can press F2 function key to create a new ledger. Next is inventory master, in which there is item master. Here there are four groups to categorize stock, like finished products, packing material, raw material and semi-finished material. As I enter on finished products, so this is a list of all our finished products, and these are our packing materials and these are our raw materials and these are semi-finished products. To create a new product, press the F2 function key, select the group and fill in the details of the product and save it. So this is how inventory is created and maintained. After that is the formula master, for which we will go on manufacturing menu, formulas. Here we have two types of formula, first of raw materials and second of packing material. Now in raw material formula, we will prepare a formula with raw material to make a semi-finished product. So basically we will be creating a formula for semi-finished product in raw material. And similarly, in packing material option, we will be creating a formula for finished product using packing materials. So firstly, let's see raw material. We'll enter on it. Select the semi-finished product for which you're creating this formula. Now this product, acid suspension, is a semi-finished product, as you can see down here. So we'll enter on it. So here there is multi-stage. If this product is a multi-stage product, then you will select from here, else you will keep this no. After that, we feed the entry date, then it's batch size, means how much bulk of quantity you want to prepare. Like I have given here 300 liter, means I want to prepare this formula according to 300 liter of acid suspicion. Next time if the order comes of 100 liter, then automatically it will get adjusted. Then define the formula number, like I have defined one. Next option is claim for. Claim for option is used for active raw materials. Means raw materials is of two types. One is active and the other is inactive. So some approved quantity is received from the government that in this item, this much active ingredient should be put, and therefore claim is only used for active raw materials. Now I have defined here 15 mg, means it will claim for every 15 milligram. And here we can feed any generic name. If you want, then you can skip it. Next is BMR type. There are two processes, one is BMR and the other is BPR. BMR means batch manufacturing record and BPR is batch processing record. So every product has to go through this. So there is tablet, liquid, capsule, food under BMR. So we select liquid under BMR type. Now I have already prepared a formula, so it has automatically loaded here. So here you see you need to keep this active raw material first. Like I have defined claim for only both of these and not for the others, because the others are non-active. And if I enter on this, then down here you see this items group is raw material. Now I enter on it. Now our cursor is on claim. Here 20 mg I have defined, means in every 15 mg of this, 20 mg of this will be used. Next is quantity. Now this was for 15 mg, but we are making 300 liters in total. So according to that 300 liter, we will calculate and define here. Next is overages. Overages means suppose if I am issuing raw materials, so some will be wasted out of them. So here we define how much extra do we want to issue against them. Like I have defined here 10% and total I am issuing 3.9960. So 10% of this plus this means the quantity that I have defined, in that much 10% will be added extra. Enter. Then is equivalent. I define the equivalent name here, suppose test. Next is add quantity at the time of costing. I have defined a quantity here as 3.9960, but I want to add 1 kg costing, so I will define here 1 kg. So what it will do is 3.9960 plus 1 kg. So whatever it calculates, that much costing will be added and shown. Next is applicable on costing, means I want to make costing applicable or not. So in this way you will load your formula. Here you see assay. Assay means purity. So here you define how much is the purity of these raw materials. Now after entering this formula, you will press the tab key. Enter on accept. So down here you see acid suspicion, finished product. So from these, I want to make these two finished product. One is acid suspicion 100 ml and the second is acid suspicion 200 ml. As I enter on this, you see down here it shows finished product group. We enter again and here in quantity you see 0.10 liter per bottle, means 100 divided by 1000 is equal to 0.10. Same is calculated for 200 ml. Now again we press the tab key and save this. So in this way we create a formula master. In the same way, you can create a formula master for all your finished products. After that is testing master. Testing master is used for quality control. There are some standard rules and parameters of testing, and we use these masters so that our products meets the expectations of these standard rules and parameters. In testing masters, we have record of analysis and certificate of analysis, whose masters we create. And similarly, we have multiple and different masters to create. So firstly, let's see how can we create these masters. Whenever we purchase raw materials or packing materials, so firstly that goes in the testing department, where its record of analysis is prepared and certificate of analysis is prepared. If it passes all the tests, then it is sent forward to production planning. Means if in case there is any defect, then it is rejected. So all this decision is done in testing, and it's done through ROA, record of analysis, and COA, certificate of analysis. So firstly, we'll enter on ROA, view and edit, select the item, after that escape, then this sheet appears. Here we feed the test which we want to conduct and its result, like the result of this product whose test was conducted, whether its result was normal or not normal. So in this way, you can self create a format for ROA according to your requirement and according to your party's requirement. Similarly, for COA, we will create a format. So according to your requirement, you can write here anything. Now we'll save this with Ctrl W. So in this way, you can create ROA and COA. Similarly, you can design bulk ROA and COA and finish ROA and COA. You just have to remember that semi-finished products will be selected for both bulk and finish. And similarly, there are other tests whose masters you can create. After creating these masters, whenever we will purchase any product, so at that time, these records will be asked automatically. So now we learned about our four masters. Now let's implement the working flow of manufacturing, which we saw in the flowchart. First was production planning. Here you can see production planning option. We can directly use production planning option, or if you have received sales order of suppose 200 bottles of acid suspension items, so according to that sale order, you can plan your production. Production planning basically shows you a list of all the items, of what all items in what all quantity will be needed in order to prepare a particular product. So here I enter. Select the product whose suppose sale order I've received, suppose acid suspension. Select yes or no if you require raw material and purchase material. And suppose I've received sales order of 1000 quantity. So I'll define here 1000 quantity. I'll define the purchase date here. So these two products purchase planning has to be done. Now we'll press the tab key. So this window appears. Here you can define the date range between which you want to view the production planning. If you only want to view acid suspension planning, then you will define its date here. Then here, if you want to see the old planning, then you will select show. Then is show items for selected planning or all planning. Then here there is show items for required or all used. Means you need to see all the items or just the required items. Then is planning for raw material, packing material or both. Then is print planning. You want to do full planning or just require last page printout. Now let's enter on view. So here a production planning chart has appeared. Here it shows what all items are to be prepared, like Amiron capsule and acid suspension. These many items will be required in these quantities. These items for Amiron and these items for acid suspension. Here it shows what all raw materials will be required and what all packing materials will be required in order to prepare acid suspension. And here it shows the total purchase required. for all these products. So everything is shown here. So in this way you can plan your production. So you can send this list to your purchase department, and then the purchase department will prepare purchase order of these required items. You can directly prepare purchase order from here. You enter on order, and these are those items whose purchase is required and in this quantity. Then press escape and enter on save purchase order to convert it into purchase order. Then comes split and save order in parts, means in how many parts do you want the purchase order to be prepared. For now we'll keep this one. Enter. And this is our purchase order window. And all those items have been loaded in this purchase order bill. We'll save this bill by pressing the end key. So now our purchase order is prepared. Now after creating the purchase order, the physical stock will be received. So now let's see how to convert purchase order into purchase bill. For that we will go on transaction, purchase, and enter on bill. Define the transaction date. Select the ledger or supplier from whom the purchase is made. Define the bill number. There's an option here, testing required. Yes, no. Means is testing required on the materials we are purchasing now or not? You might be getting testing done from outside, so you won't require testing. And if internal testing is conducted, then you'll select yes. Then your pending order window appears. This is the purchase order we just created from this supplier, aka packaging. Now we'll select it. Press space to select. Enter. Select the products you want to load in the bill. Enter. And the same materials have loaded in the purchase bill. Now we'll save it. So in this way we converted purchase order into purchase bill. Now we'll move forward to the next step, under testing of stock. So we'll be forwarding some samples of stock to the quality control department. So we'll go on manufacturing, under testing stock. So here you see these are the items which are under testing. I'll enter on suppose this one. Enter on modify. And here you type the number of samples that you are sending to the quality control department. Suppose 2 pieces. Then define the size of the pack. Then is rejected quantity. After the testing, if there are any rejected quantity, then you will define the number here. Now I'll save this. We'll enter on print. So here there are testing requisition slip which is sent to the quality control department. I'm sending 2 samples. Then is testing required. Complete as per IPBP-USP, which is a standard drug act according to which the testing is to be performed. Now we'll view it. So here it is. Requisition slip to quality control department. And this is the detail of the item. So now the item has been sent to the quality control department. After that again we'll go on under testing. Enter on modify. Now on every test, whatever testing will take place, an AR number will be defined for it, means analytic report number. So that number we define here in testing report number. And also we define a control sample number on the samples that have been sent to the QC department so that they can keep them safe, and if in future some problem arises, so they can conduct test on those samples. So here we define a sample number. We'll enter on print. Now we want to print ROA and COA. So we'll enter on ROA. So this is the ROA. You can do changes here if you want. Then we'll save it with Ctrl W. Then print it. So we can get a printout of ROA. Similarly, I can print COA and print release order. Means if you want to release this, then you will print release order. You can do tag printing. Means your stock is under testing, sample or approved. If it's approved, then you will select approved. So here this is approved material tag. So in this way you can do testing of stock in under testing stock. So now our stock has been tested. Now we'll transfer it to the store. So for that again we'll go on under testing stock. And here there's transfer, we'll enter on it. Select yes for transfer. So now our stock has been transferred. So now we have the stock in our store which is ready for production. So as the sale order will be received, we will produce those stock. So we issue raw materials and packing material to production department. So let's see how its entry will be done. For that we'll go on manufacturing. Material issue. Here we have raw material requisition, packing material requisition, additional raw material. Means if I want to issue some raw materials in the same batch or any additional packing material, and if any stock is returned, then you can easily do its entry from here. So firstly we'll enter on raw material requisition. Select production department ledger. Define slip number. Select the item. And here the same quantity is packed according to the formula, but you can change it if you want. And here we'll define the batch number where the bulk quantity will be made. Manufacturing date, its expiry date. Enter. So according to the formula, the materials have loaded. Now we'll save this formula with the tab key. Then here there are manufacturing records. You can get their prints like a requisition slip. So this is our requisition slip as per the Drug Act, WHO GMP certified, and these are the items. So this list goes to the production department, means which all items are being issued to them. Similarly, you can get tag slip prints, process sheet BMR print. Here you can print yield statement, list of equipments, list of SOPs and many more. Now after the bulk of 300 quantity is ready, so some test will be conducted. So you can get testing requisition slip, ROA, COA. Then after the bulk quantity will be packed from the issued packing material, so it will be converted into finished material, and then after that also test will be conducted on it. So all the certificates and records can be printed from here. So finished product is ready from the production department. Now that finished product will be transferred to the store. So for that we go on manufacturing, transfer note, enter on transfer, enter on production department. Now here it shows packing material not issued. So we'll have to first issue packing material. For that we go on manufacturing, material issue, and enter on packing material requisition. We will select the same item. Here we will define the quantity for which we want to issue packing material. Means for how much quantity do we want to issue packing material. Here we will define the quantity for which we want to issue packing material, means for how much quantity do we want to issue packing material. Suppose for 1000 bottles and the other for 500 bottles. then press escape. So automatically the packing material is loaded. Now we'll save this. So our finished stock is ready now. We'll transfer it to the store. And these are our two finished products. Here you'll define the received quantity. Suppose out of 1000, only 900 bottles have been prepared. The number of rejected quantity is 10, is 10 bottles. And for the second item, only 1000 bottles are ready and 10 quantity have been rejected. Now we'll save this by the tab key. Enter on accept. Then it shows the in process loss of 7 liters. Means this much quantity is left. Means our in process loss. So we'll type here. And here I can define the rates, MRP. And other rates of both our products. Now this stock is received. We can check that in the available stock status. So here you see in available stock quantity is shown. So now you can further do its sale to your depot or retailers. Now let's see some of our reports which are useful for analyzing. Here there is one option, yield option, which shows how much percentage we have achieved. Like here we had given 300 liter batch size. So out of that 293 was received. So we have achieved 97.67%. Means 97.67% of the total batch was received. So this is yield. Now after that we have some reports in the testing register. First is raw material packing material inward register. Means how many raw material and packing material inward was received. Then you can see finish inward register, bulk tested register and finish tested register. So you can view a complete testing register from here. And then in the reports tab, there are multiple reports like material used in formula. Means what all materials have been used in formulas. Production register, packing register, yield register. How many packing have not been issued. Then in daily reports menu, there are more than 2000 sale and purchase reports. From the accounts menu, you can do voucher entry, single entry, PDC checks, bank paying slip. Then in the final reports menu, there is balance sheet, profit and loss, trial balance, cash flow and fund flow and many more. So friends, this was the Marg manufacturing software. Thanks for watching. Further, for any queries, you can call on a landline number which is 011-309-6960, or you can also chat on a website which is www.margcompusoft.com. You can also SMS us on 56767. If you want to learn any feature of Marg software in detail, then you can view or download our video tutorial from our website, that is www.tutorial.margcompusoft.com.
अपने बिजनेस के लिए मैंने अपनाया मार्ग, जो रखे ख्याल मेरी बिलिंग, स्टॉक अकाउंटिंग और सभी रिटर्न्स का. मार्ग ट्रेड स्पेशलाइज्ड इन्वेंटरी एंड अकाउंटिंग सॉफ्टवेयर.